morning, students. Welcome to the next session of our class. Yesterday we discussed about the Penugolu village surrounding hills. Today our topic is Podu. What is Podu? Let us discuss. Podu is a type of agriculture which practiced by Koyas. Okay. So here in the Penugolu village, which tribal community is living? Koyas. And these Koyas use a different kind of technique to grow crops. So the Koyas, they will use a different kind of technique to grow crops, that is called Podu type. So Podu is a traditional practice. What is a Podu? It is the traditional, that means these people, which people? Yeah, Koyas. From their great grandfathers, this is their traditional way of growing crops. So the traditional practice of farming, Podu is the traditional practice of farming. And not only Koyas, but one more community also will practice the same type of growing crops. That they are Kondareddis also. They will use Podu type of agriculture used by Kondareddis also. But now in this lesson, we are going to discuss only about the Koyas. Okay. So the Koyas, they grow the crops in a different way called Podu type of agriculture. And it is the traditional practice of farming. And this is the traditional practice of farming in hilly regions. In where? In hilly regions. And this Podu is also called as shifting agriculture. Podu is also called shifting agriculture or jhum cultivation. Okay, students. So the Koyas grow crops in a distinct method called Podu. Podu is a traditional practice of farming in hilly regions. So apart from Koyas, even Kondareddis also will follow the same type of cultivation. And Podu type of cultivation is also called shifting or jhum cultivation. Okay. And this practice of shifting cultivation is also done in states like Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, students, so this type of cultivation specially practiced in hilly regions, and also this jhum cultivation is practiced in Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Arunachal Pradesh. And let us see what is actually this Podu type of cultivation. Okay, so each village, they will have one specified, means one special area. For what? For growing crops. So it's a hilly region, you all know that, isn't it? It is a hilly region. Let us see how they will grow crops. Okay, so each village has a specified area or hill that they can use for farming. So one area they will take, and in that area only they will clear the patch of forest. This is the forest only, you know, when our professors went to Penugolu village, they have seen some areas of are cleared. So that areas only this. So some of the one particular area they will choose in the forest. That area they will clean, all the trees and plants they will remove. Patch of forest they will remove and they will burn it. They will cut down the trees and they will leave them for drying and they will burn it. Okay. And then they grow crops on it. So what they will do? One area they will take, that they will clear, that all the trees, plants they will clear, and they will burn it. And then they will grow crops here for few years in this patch. Patch means a piece of land. So what they will do? For few years they will grow crops. After that, that patch of land they will leave. Few years they'll grow crops. For example, this is big forest. In this one, many acres of land they will take. All the villages, all the tribal people in that hilly region, they all will grow crops. So after few years, they will leave this land. Again, next land they will take. Next piece of land they will take for growing crops. Okay, students. And after that, they will leave that patch of land and they will allow that land again to grow like a forest. Okay. And meanwhile, they will move. Now, they left that one piece of land. Again, they'll go to the next piece of land. And meanwhile, what happens? This patch of land completely, all trees will grow. Okay. And they will go to another piece of land. And again, they will clear the forest. They will burn it. And they will grow crops. So, this way, their farms keep shifting. So, year, after few years, one piece of land, they'll grow crops. For few years, they will leave. Again, go to next piece of land. Like that, they will shift. Their agriculture work, they will shift. That's why it is called as a shifting agriculture. Isn't it? How we'll shift the house? They are shifting the? Yeah. Agriculture. They are shifting the agriculture. Okay. So, in the hills, it stops raining around November. When it stops raining in the hilly regions, it stops raining in the month of November. It stops raining in the month of November. So, then what happens when the rain stops? These koyas, they will use axe to clear patches. Patches means what? One piece of land they will take, they will clear all the trees. Okay? Forest. They clear the patches of forest in the month of December. Because rainy season ends, the rains ends in the month of November. So, in the December, they will clear all the patches of forest. Okay. And they will allow that logs. Logs means now, if they cut the trees, they'll get big logs. Isn't it? See, for example, if tree is there, they'll cut that tree, these logs will be there. This is called logs, big sticks. So, they will allow that logs to dry. So, from December to May, these logs will dry. After that, what they will do, you know, they will burn these logs. When they will burn in the month of April or May, they will burn these logs in the month of April or May. So, after burning, what will be left over? Yes, exactly. The ash will be left over. Ash means gudida. Okay. So, what will be left over after burning these logs? Yes, ash will be left over. So, again, in the month of June, it rains. When the rainy season starts, the ground is fully covered with ashes. And then what they will do in the month of June before rainy season, they will dribble. Dribble means here, the ploughing will not take place because it is the hilly region. If they will start ploughing, the topmost layer of the soil will go along with the rainwater. So, this topmost layer of the soil is very fertile. Fertile means good quality of the soil, because in this the humus will be present. For growing crops, it's very, very useful, the topmost layer of the soil. So, what they will do, they will not plough the land, just simply with the stick, with a sharp stick, they will dribble like this. They'll make like these holes. And on the in that, they will sow the seeds. Okay, with the sticks only, they will small holes, they will dig. So, this way, they sow the seeds of many crops together. See, they will not grow one crop at a time. All together, at a time, they grow many crops together. So, this is called a broadcast method. It is called what? See, all the crops together growing. Many crops together growing is called, I will write, many crops together growing is called broadcast method. Okay, many crops together growing is called what? Broadcast method. It's called broadcast method. So now actually, now in modern time, how our farmers will grow? One, two crops. That's it at a time. But they will grow many crops together. It's called broadcast method, spreading the seeds on the ground. Okay. and they do not use plough here. They do not use any plough, I said. They'll take the stick and just they will dribble. Dribble means small holes they will make with the stick and they will sow the seeds. And one of the reason for not using plough here is on the hill slopes, if they plough, they will lose the topmost layer of the soil, which is very, very fertile. So whenever it rains, what happens? If they plough the land, the topmost layer of the soil with the rainwater, it will flows. Okay, then what happens? The fertile soil becomes infertile. Okay, so farmer want the ashes and the dead leaves. Already we have seen they will burn the logs and they will remain ashes like that on the ground. So this ashes and the topmost layer of the soil, humus, these both the works like fertilizer, humus and ashes. See, they are not using any chemical fertilizers as like our farmers. So ash and the humus, the topmost layer soil, these both are the fertilizers for the soil. So these are the natural fertilizers. They are not using any chemical fertilizers, students. That means they are not damaging the environment. Even living on the hilly regions, they are growing crops, they are living, but they are not harming the environment. Is it good or not? Yes, it's very, very good method. Okay, and the main crops, let us see what type of crops. So what is jhum cultivation? They clear one patch of forest, one area, they'll grow crops. Okay, they'll cut down the forest, they will leave the logs to dry. Okay, after drying, they will burn it. Then the ash will remain on the ground. Before rain occurs, they will dribble. Just they'll make a hole with the stick and they will sow the seeds. That will do many crops together. Okay, that is called broadcast method. They grow many crops together. Okay, students, they will dribble and they will not plough the land. Why? Because whenever it rains, the topmost layer of the soil will wash away with the rainwater. So that's why they will not plough the land. Just simply they'll make a holes with the stick and they will sow the seeds. So here the humus and the ashes. Ashes means what I said? Budida. Yes, after burning what we will get? That is called ash. So this humus and ashes works like a fertilizer, students. Okay. And let us see what type of crops they will grow. In the which village? Penegolu village. Very good. See, we are very lucky that we are visiting through the lesson, through the textbook to different villages which we didn't hear also. Some of you may be heard, some of maybe you not heard, isn't it? So, let us see what type of crops they grow. So, the main crops, let us write first, the main crops. What are the main crops? Let us see. The main crops are jowar. Jowar, you all know very well. Jonnalu. Okay. Next, mokkajonna means corn. Okay. Then tubers. Tubers means here given dumpalu. Like potato, sweet potato. They are called tubers. Then millets. See, millets you all know very well. Nowadays very famous. Samulu, karralu, they are all called millets. Samulu, karralu. Okay. Then they will grow sesamum seeds. Sesamum means nubulu. Sesamum means nubulu. Then they are growing red gram, green gram. Red gram, green gram. And vegetables like brinjal. Okay, then chilies, green chilies. Then they are growing gongura. You know gongura? Yes, Rosalis leaves. Okay, and see, so what are the main crops here? Jowar, corn, tubers, millets, sesamum seeds, red gram, brinjal, green chilies, and gongura. These are the main crops here. Okay. And they grow mixed crops. And here irrigation only rains. ओके सो हाउ दे विल इरिगेट रेन्स दे ग्रो मिक्स्ड विदाउट एनी इरिगेशन सो नॉट वाटर फ्रॉम वंशधारा कैनल एंड ऑल सी हियर सॉरी दे डिपेंड अपॉन द रेन्स ओनली नो इरिगेशन हियर ओनली दे डिपेंड अपॉन द रेन्स एंड वॉट एवर दे ग्रो इट इज सफिशियंट फॉर देम फॉर सिक्स मंथ्स वॉट एवर दे ग्रो इट्स सफिशियंट फॉर सिक्स मंथ्स फॉर देम एंड दीज फील्ड्स आर नियर टू द फॉरेस्ट ऑलरेडी इन द फॉरेस्ट रीजन ओनली सम पार्ट दे विल कट एंड यूज इज इन डिट सो हियर वॉट विल अट्रैक्ट यस एग्जैक्टली द एनिमल्स विल अट्रैक्ट वेन दे ग्रो क्रॉप द एनिमल्स मे कम एंड स्पॉइल देर एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड्स सो टू प्रोटेक्ट दे fields this koyas they will build guard called manche guard means to protect okay this is called manche manche so one thin layer of cloth or something to protect that under that see if birds also there not only animals even birds will come and eat isn't it so that's how to protect their crops manche guard they will use nets or some cloth or some other dry leaves or something with on the top they will put it to protect their crops okay and we read earlier that farming is done on a particular plot of land yes already we discussed that under the podu type of agriculture on one patch of land will be cleared and on that land they will grow crops for few years again they will leave that land and go to the next patch of forest isn't it so in olden days on an average each family so let us see how much of area they used to clear and use shall I rub this okay so in the olden days how they used to take the land See many families will be there. Each family, how much land to be taken? How they have distributed without fighting? Let us discuss. So, in olden days, an average each family they used to clear 2 to 2.5 acres of forest land. Acres of forest land. Okay. So under podu type of agriculture, each family how much land they will take 2 to 2.5 acres of land per each family. So the average yield of jowar so per acre 2.2 to 2.5 acres of forest land. So in each acre of land they will grow 250 kilograms of jowar. 250 kilograms of jowar. Okay, the average yield of jowar per acre is 250 kilograms per acre. For each acre, they will get 250 kilograms of jowar. So each family harvested about 600. Each family harvested how much? 600 kilograms. Kilograms means what? Kgs. Okay, each family 600 kilograms of jowar, and apart from this, 150 to 250 kilograms of millets. Understood, students? How they have distributed land? Each family 2 to 2.5 acres of forest land they used to clear and use for growing crops. So in that. Per acre they will get 250 kgs of jowar. In one acre 250 kgs of jowar. That means each family will get 600 kilograms of jowar and 150 to 250 kilograms of millets. Okay, so this was about the olden days. But recently, earlier large forest areas were available. So in the olden days, large area of forest used to be available. More forest regions, isn't it? That's time no cutting down of trees, isn't it? But now the area available for podu has decreased. Why decreased? Earlier there was much land for growing crops for the Penugolu villages. But now, why this land has decreased? So, each family used to take 2 to 2.5 acres in olden days. But if to present now, the area for Podu has decreased. Each family, 1 to 1.5 acres. That means for each family, 1 acre is reduced. 1 to 1.5 acres. Okay? Then, that means now the crop is also decreased. The harvest, see, when land automatically decreases, the crop also decreases. Here, see, 2 to 2.5 acres of land per acre, 250 kilograms of jowar. Like that, 600 kilograms of jowar they used to get and 150 to 250 kilograms of millet they used to get. Now, the land area has decreased. That means this 600 kilograms may be become to 300. This may be 100 or 125. That's it. So, the crops also reduced now. That means the availability of food grains are reduced for each family. At the same time, the people are in the Penugolu village, the people are forced to come back to the same plot early. Earlier, how they used to do? For a few years, in one region, they used to grow, again go to the next region. But now, not many years, within a few years, they have to come back to their land. Because now land area also decreased in this forest. Why decreased? Let us see. So, the rotation cycle has become smaller. So, the soil is not able to recover its fertility. Yes. So, why they used to leave one patch of land and go to the next piece of land, you know, because if the few years they'll grow continuously, again they go to next land and they will leave that piece of land to grow all the trees and plants. With that, what happens again for, see, first land they grow for few years. Again, next they grow. Again, they grow somewhere, they grow somewhere. To come to the first land, the patch of land which they used, after many years, they used to come to that first patch of land. That means, till that time, that soil again, it will recoup the nutrients naturally. Because in that again, first piece of land for many years, they did not used. So, naturally, because of rains, winds, it will take nutrients naturally from the nature. So, in that way, the soil fertility used to be increased. But now, the acres of land for each family decrease and they are forced to come back to their first land very soon. That means that fertility, the soil cannot recover the fertility. Recover means again it cannot take fertility because very soon they are coming. Very soon they are coming back to the land. See, zoom shifting agriculture means one piece of land they will clear in the forest. They will leave the logs. After drying, they will burn it. Then they'll get ash. Ash works like a fertilizer. They'll grow crops. Like that, forest will be very, very big. So, after maybe 20 years or 10 years after, they'll come to the first patch of land. Till that time, these many years, again, that soil will get lot of fertility. Fertility means the quality of the soil increases. But now, they are coming very soon back to this land which they used earlier. So, the soil cannot recover the fertility. Okay, have you understood, student, about the Podu type of agriculture? So, I would like to ask you the few questions, then I will end my session. Okay. Name the surrounding regions of Penugolu. Recapitulation. Surrounding regions, yesterday we have seen Nallaguttar, Karregutta, Chhattisgarh on the north. So, that answer. Next, where is Vazidu Mandal? Next, what are the crops grown in Penugolu? Just now we have seen what the crops they'll grow. Okay. So, these question answers I'll post you. Thank you. Have a nice day.